what's up? This is your girl Barbie, and you're watching Caribbean TV. Keep it locked. It's Barbie, baby.
We have seen it work in New York, where they have about 23, 24 small organizations all working on their own thing, and coming together has made such a difference. You guys can do it. We know what you can do. We have seen it this weekend. I hope you think about it, and if you need help to do it, and if we can help, we will help you. When we talk about the diaspora and coming to you to get interested and re-engage and to help Belize in the correct way to development, it's not a one-way street. We're not just asking. We are telling you that reconnecting with your country, investing in Belize is good business. But more than that, we are offering that the embassy is there to support you. We are there to improve our services because you're important. And one very important reason why we are in the United States and why we have so many consulates across the country is because of the importance that you present for us. In that context, when the Foreign Minister of Belize visited last year, and for many months we have heard that the people of Chicago have the need to be able to apply, need to be able to obtain their passports, apply for their passports in Chicago. I want to tell you that the government of Belize has listened to you. A passport issuing office is being established. The machine has been ordered. It should be here in May. You ask for it, we give it to you because you are important to us. The last issue I want to mention, and this is very important, I have to tell you that I am so happy to see so many young people and children participating in the activities this weekend. It is an issue that we have been grappling with for a while. How do we get the new generation of Belizeans to take pride in their country, to absorb their culture, and to keep flying the flag the way you are doing it? We have been trying to find a way to do it, and you have shown us how. Just get them involved. Thank you for getting them involved. This is an example we have to take to the rest of our communities across the United States. Chicago, you have shown us how. Thank you. And now, ladies and gentlemen, it is my great honor and privilege to introduce the Honorable Dean Barrow, the Minister of Finance and Prime Minister of Belize. The Honorable Dean Barrow needs very little introduction. He has been in office since February 2008. He is committed to the task of national reconstruction. He is committed to the quick implementation of his party's reform agenda, providing the right checks and balances, including penalties. And he is committed to restoring to the people the rightful authority over their elected officials. But more than those commitments which he has articulated and stressed and repeated on several times during his visit, our distinguished leader has gone beyond those words, and he has actually committed to action. His scrupulous adherence to transparency, honesty, clean government, that is what we need in a leader. Ladies and gentlemen, the Prime Minister of Belize.
Thank you so very much, Ambassador. Members of the head table, ladies and gentlemen, how good it is to see so many of you here this evening, and what a wonderful program we've had. I want to begin, therefore, by congratulating all the performers that entertained us so splendidly this evening. First and foremost, of course, the children. Can we hear it for the children, please? And then the Belizean American dancers. And of course, the Garifuna dancers. I thought that when I heard that the Belizean American dancers had won every category, every prize there was to win in terms of the carnival here in Chicago, it struck me that while all Caribbeans know how to wind their waist, the Belizean Americans had a special advantage because they included in their routine a little bit of the punta, you see. And no other Caribbean country knows how to punta. Dingy way. So that gives me an opportunity to salute again the Garifuna dancers. I want to tell you how very proud we are of you. It's important that, in your case especially, the younger members of the community are participating. I want to let you know that we take very seriously at home the preservation of Garifuna culture, the effort to hand down the traditions from generation to generation, and that is why your government has in fact found funds for additional classroom for the Gulisi school in Dangriga.